Hello, and welcome to this demonstration of GIIN validation with AEOI Hub. The Global Intermediary Identification Number, GIIN, is a key part of FATCA reporting. Issued to financial institutions by the IRS, it's then used to identify that FI in the FATCA report. It's really important that GIIN is reported accurately, because getting it wrong even just by one character could cause the whole submission to fail, be rejected. Fortunately, help is at hand because the IRS publish a full list of all of the foreign financial institutions which is available to view, search online, and it can also be downloaded in a number of formats. And the format that we use with AEOI Hub is CSV, because we can then use that to search and find the details of the GIIN that you've entered in the template. In terms of the validations that we perform in the template, firstly we check where a GIIN is required and prompt you of that fact by checking the local rules of the jurisdiction that you're filing in. We secondly check the format of the GIIN that you enter to ensure that it's valid. And thirdly, we then offer an option to look up the GIIN on the FFI list to check that it's there and compare it to the FI name. Because in many jurisdictions, if you get the name wrong in your submission compared to what they're expecting from the FFI list, it can cause it to be rejected. Let's take a look at the template. In the AEOI Hub template, we perform the same GIIN validation checks wherever GIIN is present and valid, relevant. This is on the submitter level and also on the financial institutions, and if it's relevant, for the sponsoring financial institution. I'm going to take a look in the submitter form, and you can first of all notice that it's prompting me that the GIIN is required for this particular jurisdiction. And if I start to type in, you can see that it's also checking the format, and until I've completely entered this, it will now remove that warning because it can see that's a valid format. I then have the option to click on this Check GIIN button, which is going to look up the FFI list and check for the presence of that GIIN. In this case, it's not actually found that. There's no match on the list. But that's fine because I've realised that I've mistyped that. I'm just going to try again and check. So it's now found a match for that GIIN, but the name that appears on the list is slightly different from the name that I've got here. And that could cause this to be rejected. But I can fix that so it's got the AEOI Hub Limited on the list, but I've just got the AEOI Hub. So I can fix that, and now see I've got a nice green tick to indicate that's all valid. I'm just going to show you one other feature. If I go back and change that back to how it was with the mismatch, if I click on Update, you can see I have a warning. This is invalid. I'll choose to fix later. But if I later run our full validation checks across all of the data in the file, it will identify this as one of our errors, and that will then appear on the errors sheet. Submitter name is different from the published list. We do have an option, if I go back into the submitter form, to ignore GIIN mismatch warnings. The reason we've included that is it may be that you're aware that the details on the published FFI list are in the process of being updated, or for a very new financial institution, it may not be on that list yet, which is updated monthly. So in that case, if you select that option to ignore mismatches, what it will do when you run the full validation checks is that that error will not be reported. And you'll see that my validation checks are now complete with no errors identified. We hope that you found that video useful. Look out for further updates on our YouTube channel and also on our LinkedIn and Twitter.